A recent report by KPMG showed 2023 was a difficult year for the fintech market globally, with both total fintech investments, that's $113.7 billion, and the number of fintech deals at just 4,547, experiencing their weakest results since 2017. But there is a bright spot, prop tech investments, which more than tripled to from $4.1 billion to $13.4 billion between 2022 and 2023. Our next guest is one of the largest venture builders in the region, which invested in one called Houseify. Glenn Estrella, head of ideation and acceleration at 917 Ventures, joins us live. Hi, Glenn. Welcome back to Market Edge. Good to see you.
Omi, good morning, and thank you for having me back.
Good morning. So first of all, how big of an investment is Houseify for 917 Ventures, and where do you want to take it over the next 3 years?
Great question. Before I answer that, I'd like to point out that Houseify started out from our Velocity program in 2022. It's an innovation challenge within the Globe and Ayala Group. And it's a six-week challenge, and it comes from both either managers, supervisors, and executives coming together and trying to solve problems within the business realm we operate. Mm-hmm. And Houseify was the winner of that.
All right.
And an investment we made is, I think, it's very modest, and where we want to take it is related to what problem is trying to solve. And the way we approach the ecosystem approach, right? So we are here to help solve pain points with the real estate brokers and agents and offices. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the pain point rests in terms of the how long it takes to process a lead, to find a lead, and from meeting to closure and sale, right? Sale and closure. And that's what we're trying to solve. We've discovered that matching buyers and sellers is not as easy as it looks. It takes longer. And in an older life, I spent time as a real estate agent myself. And if I had a tool like this, my life would have been a lot easier and maybe different today. So in 3 years, we're looking at trying to solve the problems of our real estate brokers and agents of about 133,000 of them growing to 2038. By doing that, we'll be able to speed up growth in that sector.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's talk about some of the key metrics that you mentioned earlier, the time it takes to match a buyer and the seller. What is the current average time, and what will this tool do to the time?
Yes, so first of all, finding the lead. It takes, normally they don't have you operate within your realm of network. Then the other option is you venture on your own in advertising, either in social media. And even finding a lead takes about 2 months, right? And filtering it takes another about 3 to 4 weeks. The sale itself, depending on the nature of the property, especially if it's land, takes 6 months or longer. But it's shorter selling if it's actually condominiums or homes between a month to 2 months. Mm-hmm. So there are different timelines in each stage. And what we're trying to do first is vetting the lead, right? By the time we give it to our brokers, we have vetted most of them for them for their consideration. Mm-hmm. And there are also options where some want volume of leads, but they'll have to do their own vetting as well. Mm-hmm. So that's the first thing to solve first. And I think that's where the group advantage comes into play, right? All the data we can generate and trying to for them. There are also pockets of what we say localities, right? And of course, it's heavily focused on the CBD, but we do see properties outside the CBD areas or the city areas that I think would also benefit from this.
Mm-hmm. Just a quick question. I know that you have plans to onboard 20,000 brokers in the short term. And what will that mean? Will these brokers be full-time exclusive brokers of Houseify, or are these freelancer brokers or brokers who are already with existing brokerage houses?
Oh, no, they're not exclusive to us. We are an additional tool for them. Mm-hmm. And that journey, the way to see us is we're an add-on to their portfolio. There's a lot of digitalization that needs also that has to be brought to this segment, and I think by solving that again, we are able to shorten and accelerate their ability to find customers, vet them, and basically accelerate their real estate listings as well.
Just a correction. I know you plan to onboard 2,000 this year, 2,000 brokers this year. And how do you make money from this? For every successfully closed deal or for every lead found?
No.
How does it work?
No, we're a tool, right? So we're a software tool, and they subscribe to our different packages, and each one they get leads, they can upload their listings. We provide them different variations of qualified leads depending on the plan, and they'll have access to our CRM tool that we're continually improving and enhancing, and that's practically it. So, and again, shortening that time for them on their inventory and matching their customers. There's also this growth in terms of our kababayan outside the Philippines looking for investments here. And I think that's also an area of opportunity for them. So we're really our ears to the ground for our brokers on this one.
Yeah, because my next question is why now? I know that it's been 3 years in the making. You said it earlier, but why are you making a big push for this now? At a time when vacancy rate remains high, close to 20%, and is expected to go back down to pre-pandemic levels of closer to 10% in 2 to 3 years' time.
That's a great question. I get asked that all the time, and we think about it this way. When we make these investments and these bets, we look at it further ahead, and the bet is we want to be where the ball will be, not where it is. It doesn't look, probably depending on the lens you wear, it's not, oh, they shouldn't be there. But we do believe that if you think further ahead, at least 5 years from now, where we will be, where the ball will be. And I think when you look at it as an ecosystem play, it will genuinely expand either through partnerships or organically for ourselves and where we want to play in this market.
And I wonder, what are some of the new technologies that you're investing in to support the real estate industry using this tool, to help industry players make informed decisions, respond quicker to trends, and to take on more complex projects? We remember a few years ago, the early prop tech players were focused more on efficiencies, like lower energy costs, automating repetitive tasks. But I imagine that has shifted, that has grown to be able to address more complex questions today. So what are some of the cutting-edge technologies that you're using, and what are some of the complex questions that you and your tool may be able to answer?
Basically, two parts, I would say. One is obviously understanding customer data that flows through the platform, and so that we can leverage with our with and you match that with obviously very easy, I mean, accessible tools of AI now. They're a lot more accessible now than they were like even a year ago, and through their APIs, we're able to use them, right, and enhance how data is read, how we match these customers to our buyers, and how we actually look for similar audiences in terms of the buyers. It's no longer just location, right? There's so many much behavior on the data that we can analyze. The convenience on the platform will naturally grow, right? And there's a lot of tools right there for that. But the relatively new things applied, I wouldn't say really relatively new, except for the AI part, is really more focused on the use of data and AI together and leveraging that, democratizing that for our broker community.
All right. Glenn, just zooming out a little bit to 917 Ventures as the venture builder, 900 plus ideas vetted, 29 ventures launched. You have 13 companies in your portfolio, including GCash, Gogoro. For those who are looking at your screen, they're up there. I can see Consulta MD, Chroma Entertainment, and AdSpark. I wonder, what's the sense that you're getting from the investment climate today? Is it the end of easy money when you think about the challenging macro environment?
That's true. Investors are a lot more prudent and want to see a lot more analysis into what we do. I think the fundamentals are, I think, got a bit lost in the past few years when money was just overflowing and I think valuations were a little bit too high. I When you say easy money, I think it's more prudent investing, right? And where to make your bets. And I think working as a, you know, operating as a corporate venture builder, I think we do have the advantage to look at an ecosystem play. And we won't probably play in everything, but we will make our bets in the ecosystem that we work in.
Mm-hmm.
That way, we'll be able to return value to our shareholders.
And do you think you're going to be making more investments this year than last year? How many companies are you looking at?
Well, the way we look at it is, we will look at it the same as last year, but we do have this back of the envelope thinking where, you know, it won't be as easy. But I think that's also the middle part is the discipline to find out where the best bets are. So it will be a combination of new things. It'll be a probably a combination also of new things and doubling down on what we have today.
All right. Exciting times ahead. On that note, Glenn, thank you so much for joining us this morning and for the insights. We look forward to more exciting news from Houseify and 917 Ventures. See you soon.
Thank you.
Time now to zip through